Hi YouTube, welcome back to my channel, Ashley Empowers. Thank you for tuning in to another episode of Dating with Purpose. And today I'm super excited to introduce you all to my husband, the fit pastor, Carrington Brown. Say something.
What's up, YouTube?
So today we are going to have a special host, which is a dear friend of mine, Elena Gill, who will be interviewing Carrington and I for our interview of Dating with Purpose. So I just want to thank everyone who has tuned in and who has subscribed to the channel. And I would like to introduce our host, Elena Gill.
Hi YouTube, my name is Elena. I'm the guest host for today. I am so grateful to be interviewing one of my favorite couples, Ashley and Carrington Brown. The purpose of this show is to showcase young Christian couples that are dating with purpose, so others will be inspired to keep God first in their relationships. So we're gonna get straight to it. So Ashley and Carrington, tell everyone your story.
You can start off first, baby.
You want to start?
Yeah, you can start first.
Okay, well, Carrington and I, we met last July, in July of 2013.
July 5th.
July 5th, 2013. And how it all started was we actually met on Instagram. And it was interesting, to make long story short, he was liking a whole lot of my pictures. And I went to his Instagram page and I started liking a whole lot of his pictures. But when I saw his Instagram, he looked really familiar to me. And so I was starting to scroll and I'm like, where do I know him from? I thought I knew him from back home because I'm originally from Kansas. And then I put two and two together and I saw that he had some pictures and that he played football. And he played football for the same university that I went to, and we actually went there at the same time, but we didn't know each other and we never spoke, and we had a lot of mutual friends. So we started dating, well, we started talking, then we started dating, then we started courting, then we got engaged, and now we're married. But it's definitely been a journey of really just growing as a couple.
Everything she said.
Okay. So what does dating with purpose mean to you guys? I know you talk about it a lot, but what does it mean personally to you both?
To me, dating with purpose means realizing and understanding why you date. To realize that it's not just to go out on dates and kiss and do whatever people do in dating. You know, it's, you have to realize that it's a ministry and a bigger purpose behind being in a relationship. It's not just about you. Like, you're together with that person that God places you with to affect lives and bring about change in the world and just the people and environment around you. So you have to really spend a lot of time with God and just find the reason why behind it and the why God put you with who he put you with.
And I would say dating with purpose is intentional dating. When me and Carrington first got together, we had conversations early on where the relationship was going to go. Like, we both knew that we wanted to be married, and I'm grateful that we both had the same vision because we were able to structure our dating to lead to marriage. So I think that's dating with purpose, because at the end of the day, our purpose was to get married, and neither one of us thought it was weird to talk about marriage the first couple weeks. Because me, I'm just like, you know, I don't want to waste any more time. And I tried to weed out men that did not have that same vision early on.
Yeah. Good. So you guys have both been very open about how you met on Instagram. Would you encourage other singles to use social media to meet someone?
I wouldn't say use that as your primary source. Actually, when it comes to meeting someone else, like your significant other, I wouldn't even say to look for them. I just say focus on you and building yourself up into the person that you would want to be in a relationship with, so that when God brings you in contact with that person, everything is all good and already and set to where you need to be. And, you know, in a lot of times in the places where you're strong, like, for example, us, she's real strong in areas that I'm not too strong in, and vice versa. So it's like in that time alone, in your season of single, you should just build yourself up to be prepared to be in a relationship, in a serious relationship.
I agree. But I also don't think that finding a mate online is a bad idea. I mean, just quickly, you know, I think anytime someone dates someone, regardless if they met them online, you're going to do a little Facebook stalking to see who this person really is. And I was able to, I mean, I guess, you know, I did that with Carrington, you know, when I first started talking to him and we met on Instagram. So I'm like, well, hold on, let me see if he's on Facebook. And we were actually already Facebook friends and I didn't even know him. But I remember scrolling through some of his pictures, and specifically I saw a picture that he had up of, he was like getting his hair cut or something. But in the comments, another young guy was asking Carrington how to build a relationship with the Lord. And Carrington was like commenting and giving him advice and feedback and tips. And this is before I really knew him. So I was like, oh, okay. Like, you know, it showed me a little bit about him. But of course, you know, social media, people only show the highlights of their life. Mm-hmm. So it's good to maybe use that as an introduction to someone, but really spend time to actually get to know the person that you meet.
And also with that, with the mutual friends that we had, she went back and asked him, who is this guy and what is he about? So I assume she got good feedback because we're married.
Yeah.
You know.
So it's okay for the most part.
Yeah.
Okay. It's very important to keep God first. And I hear you both say it constantly, being around you two. That's one of y'all's, you know, biggest sayings. You say, keep God first always. Could you give some examples of ways to keep God first in someone, you know, with their in a relationship and they're trying to, you know, make their relationship dating with purpose? And, you know, could you just give some tips on how to keep God first in that?
You want to lead?
You got it.
Tips on keeping God first. initially, well, starting off, I would have to say you have to first build a relationship with God. Know who God is. Know why he's so amazing. Know why he's so great. And once you fall in love with God, keeping him first would become a lot easier. In relationships, a lot of times you get to the point with being around someone who you're very attracted to, you just want to just do stuff. Just be open, be free, and just let everything flow. But you have to stop yourself and be like, wait a minute, like, would God approve of this? Would this be okay with God? I was in love with God before I liked or loved or fell in love with this person. So if I did this, would God approve of it? And also, you just have to just spend enough time in the Bible to where you know the do's and don'ts of relationships. Like I said before, the meaning of a relationship, the why behind it, and to just follow those simple rules, because all the rules in the Bible, yes, they're rules somewhere, but at the same time, it's all just to better you and yourself. So.
I think that's good, but you were asking like the importance of keeping God first.
The importance, and also just like, how do you all keep God first in your relationship?
Well, one, God doesn't bless any mess, right? And I think just from the relationships that I've been in the past, where God has not been first or the priority, all the relationships have failed. So I think with us, we were really intentional about keeping God first because we wanted this to end in marriage and we wanted God's hand to be on our relationship. And ways that we kept God first is, one, we talked about God. You know, early on, I knew Carrington's beliefs. He knew my beliefs. We went to church together. He visited my church. I visited his church. We prayed together. We've dating, engaged, everything. We did so many fasts together. And I mean, we really just premarital counseling, like everything that we've done, God has been the center of it. And at the end of the day, our relationships with God have strengthened with us being together. They haven't weakened with us being together. Because I know in the past, my relationship with God would weaken because I'd put that other person first. But with him, he pushes me closer. And I know that I've helped him in his relationship with God. So I really think it's just respecting God so much and knowing that it's our union's going to be blessed because he brought us together. But we also wanted to make sure that we're pleasing him in our relationship. And we do that by keeping him first.
Thank you, Ashley and Carrington. So with that being said, I know you guys are very open about talking about how you remained abstinent during your whole dating process. How could you encourage singles to, you know, remain abstinent, and how important it is to do that when you are pursuing marriage?
Man, how do you remain abstinent?
Talk about the struggle.
Well, we want to motivate them. So let's start off by saying it's possible.
Okay.
Very good.
You have to know it's possible. As hard as it may seem, it's possible. It takes a lot of self-discipline.
Yeah.
It takes a lot of praying. Mm. You have to get your flesh in check. Because when it comes to premarital sex and just having sex before you're married, it's all about pleasing the flesh. And it's a temporary pleasure. Like, it's temporary. Like, after it's done, it goes away, and then conviction comes. And conviction feels a lot worse than the joy and good feeling of sex.
Okay.
So, it's possible. How to do it? Grow your relationship with God. Realize that God comes first. Keep him number one. And just don't put yourselves in positions to where the temptations or the opportunity to do it will come about. For example, if you're trying to be absent in a relationship, it's not smart to go over her house at midnight to watch movies and cuddle, because you're going to get tired. Y'all going to be close. It's probably going to be a romantic movie. It's nighttime, so that's when you get in the mood. So it's like you're setting yourself up for failure from the get-go.
Right.
So just don't put yourself in that position to where the struggle is going to be realer than it already is.
Yeah. Because the struggle is real. And me and Carrington know that, because in the beginning, we did have our slip-ups. And we really had to pray and repent. And we actually went to a church where a pastor prayed for us, and we prayed the prayer of repentance and really decided, okay, this is before we got engaged. We decided that is one of our goals, to please God in this area of practicing abstinence. And we know from the past relationships that when sex was the foundation, or premarital sex was it, if we had premarital sex, those relationships ended in heartbreak. So we stopped, and we started being abstinent. We stopped kissing, And it was hard. It was really hard. But the fact that we knew that we both wanted to be married, we knew it was temporary. So that was a good thing, you know, because we're like, okay, we have to resist these feelings and we have to try to avoid temptation. But at the end of the day, we know that there is light at the end of the tunnel. Although we made this decision when we were still dating, we weren't engaged or anything like that. We got engaged a few months after, but still, I mean, we were engaged for like 5 months.
Yeah.
But yeah, about 5 months.
Yeah, about five.
So it's temporary. And really just knowing that when you honor God, He honors you. Mm-hmm. And just from our failed relationships, we knew we wanted to do something different. So abstinence is extremely important. And I really just feel like it shows God that it's not about us, it's about Him.
That was my next question, how important it was, but you already answered, so thank you, Ashley. Now we're going to roll right into some of our social media guests who submitted questions to you all. I know you had asked, you know, on our different networks, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, for people to submit questions if they had some. So I'm going to go ahead and roll right into that. Okay. Well, it looks like the first one from Instagram, Chantel_Charisse. How does one go about courting with someone who is in ministry, i.e. a pastor or a minister?
You want to start? Okay.
A pastor slash minister.
Okay, well, I courted a pastor slash minister. One, I don't know if she's asking because that's her desire to court someone that's a pastor or minister. If it's her desire, I would tell her to wait. Like, let them pursue you and approach you. If she's asking that question from the standpoint of how do you do it with a pastor or minister, just make sure that your beliefs are the same. Because just because someone's a pastor or a minister does not necessarily mean that they're practicing abstinence. It doesn't necessarily mean that they're courting to get married. You would think that, being that they're a pastor or a minister, but sometimes that's not their intention. Yeah. Unfortunately. So really, I would say first let them pursue you to make sure your beliefs are the same.
Carrington, you have anything to add?
I agree with everything he said, but on the point of if she's wanting to court a man of God in the ministry already, and courting isn't on his mind or he hasn't brought it up, she might need to leave him alone because he knows better. And then I'm going to leave it at that.
Okay. All right. the next one from Facebook, and I kind of like this question because that's kind of where I'm at right now too. It's from Donna Denise. How do you be patient while waiting? I mean, it's like sometimes you feel like, oh my gosh, I'm still here. How do you deal with being patient while waiting?
You deal with it by realizing that, like she said earlier, there's a light at the end of the tunnel. Why not save yourself until marriage? Why not be abstinent for a couple months or one or two years and be able to have sexual intimacy with somebody that you know is really about you? You're going to be, he or she is going to be there for the rest of your life. And that's the person that God blessed you with for the rest of your life, put on this earth perfectly for you. And why not wait those 1 or 2 years or a couple months or however long you're in that process and be able to do it freely with no conviction for the rest of your life? Mm-hmm. And yeah, that's my take on it.
Okay. I think that's a good take, but what's the question again?
How do you be patient while waiting and kind of like embracing your singleness at the moment? Like, how do you be content with just, oh, I'm single, I'm waiting for my Boaz. What do I do?
Jesus was single.
That's true. And I think, excuse me, I think what Carrington said is dead on. Sometimes people, it's not 1 or 2 years of being single. I know people, women that have been single for years and they still have not met that match. Mm-hmm. And only God knows that answer why. But advice to those women that are still waiting, first off, I've absolutely been there. Over a year ago, I was single, wasn't dating anyone, didn't have any prospects, mm-hmm. but marriage was a desire. And I don't even like the word dealing, because it's a blessing. Like, that season is such a blessing. And how I would embrace it is a better word I would use, mm-hmm. is by doing you. You know, one, building your relationship and developing that rhythm of you spending time with God on your own. I would also say to do things within your purpose. Like me, you know, I'm finishing graduate school. I started my own business. I went on mission trips. Like, I stayed busy. It wasn't like I was just waiting around. Don't get it twisted. Every day I walked out of my house, I was looking cute and fly just in case I would happen to meet somebody. But I didn't go out to meet somebody. Like, I would go wherever God had me go for the day. And that's, you know.
Right.
So it's just like, do what God is telling you to do.
Right.
God already knows your desires. And when he sees you're being patient and being faithful in the things that he's called you to do, in his word, it says, you know, you've been faithful over small things, I'll bless you with many. Mm-hmm. So it's just like showing him, like, okay, God, I'm embracing this season, mm-hmm. and I'm telling you, he will send your mate, usually, like, you know, it'll be like, oh, like, one, I didn't know it was going to be that type of person,
right.
because a lot of people are looking for a certain type.
Mm-hmm.
But you have to realize that God is going to bless you on who is best for you, not necessarily what your type is.
Mm-hmm.
So it's going to be someone who may not be your type, and also when you probably don't expect it.
That's good.
It was.
Anything else, Carrington?
She hit all of them.
Okay.
Like.
Thank you, Ashley. Okay. I think I don't actually have time for any more, but I'll try to squeeze one in because this is really good. This is from someone on Instagram, Loveet__. Sorry about that if I butchered your name. How do you know if he's the one or not? And actually, I want to kind of switch your question up. Carrington, did you know that Ashley was the one? Because I know that's what all the women highly anticipate. Like, how do you know?
As crazy as it sounds, I found out that Ashley was the one during one of our mess ups. It was like 10 days in mm. to our relationship, we slipped up.
Mm.
And Ashley kicked me out the house.
Mm.
And I was on like the second stair from the bottom in the apartment crying. On the phone with the president of the campus ministry that I was a part of, just like, oh, I feel like she's the one, but I heard her feeling, she kicked me out of the house, just crying. But when I meet women, God always talks to me instantly.
Mm-hmm.
God says, Carrington, leave her alone. Carrington, she's cool to be your friend, that's it.
Mm-hmm.
That's how God, when I met Ashley, God didn't say anything.
Oh.
So I'm like, I don't know. So the next day after this happened, she kicked me out the house. I was at Chipotle, and it's crazy. My counselor from high school came in, so me and her started sitting down and eating and talking and talking and talking. And Ashley sent me a message that a friend of hers sent her, and it was on the gist of be prayerful of your man of God and your relationship. The devil is going to attack you guys mentally, and this. And after I finished reading that text message, God said, "Oh, Carrington, I want to remind you, this is the woman that I made for you. She's perfectly for you. You're going to be with her for the rest of your life.
Wow.
Pursue her, because this is it. None after that." So
mm.
that's when I knew it. And then after that is when I began calling her my rib, because once God told me, everything got
so
clear.
Weird.
And it was like, yeah. Okay, I'm cool with that. Mm-hmm. She's amazing. She can be my wife. That's okay with me.
Yeah.
And I just accepted it and ran with it. I'm so lucky.
You are. And Ashley, real quickly, how did you know he was the one?
That's a simple question. I mean, I had peace about it. I'm just like, dang, Carrington, you just really, he really just gave a truthful answer about the 10 days and me kicking him out.
So oh, like, my gosh.
But yeah. No, like,
I've heard that story before.
Yes. Excuse me. That's true. But how I knew he was the one is I had peace. And that's my number one answer. Okay. I had complete peace about it. Nothing was forced. Carrington pursued me like a man is supposed to pursue a woman. Mm-hmm. A lot of people are in relationships where the women, and I've been in a relationship where I have tried to force everything. Mm-hmm. And the men, I was stepping out of my role as a woman, but with Carrington, like, I really did fall back, and he pursued me like he was supposed to. And I had peace about it the entire time, even through the mess ups. I was like, you know, I kicked him out that day because I'm like, you know, this is not the path I'm trying to be on. You know, I am trying to build my relationship with God. Like, I thought that since we messed up, there was no hope. Mm-hmm. But there is hope. And I think that's the beauty of our story, is that it started off on the wrong foot, but it ended off on a beautiful one. And at the end of the day, it was God's peace will always follow. And that's how I knew. Yeah.
And let me just add this here real quick. I left this out of my story, but before she kicked me out, what she said to me sticks to me every day. She said, "Carrington, my relationship with God is more important than my relationship with you. If you cannot be the man of God I need you to be in my life, then you will not be in my life. Bye."
Setting it straight.
Yes.
And yeah. That stuck. And it's kind of like, you know, you give out what you're going to receive. So basically, she set the standard high and it remained high. And, you know, just because y'all messed up, she knew, you know, you knew what she was expecting.
I did.
And you came correct the next time.
So. I did.
All right. Well, I just have one more. What advice can you give to singles? I know we've been back and forth about it, but, you know, again, just as, you know, we're trying to help us people. So, yeah, just real quickly, what advice could you give to singles, if any? Just one more thing to maybe throw in that we haven't talked about already.
That we haven't talked about already. All of the advice that comes to my mind, I feel like we've already touched on. Pursue God with everything you have. Prepare yourself for that relationship before you get in that relationship. And as she just said, don't be forceful with it. Like, if someone loves you and somebody wants to be with you, there's nothing to force. Like, I see a lot of times women on social media talking about chase me and chase. What? Like, if I like you and you like me, why do I have to chase you? Like, you shouldn't have to chase what wants you back. So just be patient, love God, fall in love with God, prepare yourself, and just be ready when that blessing comes your way.
And my advice is everything he just said, and I'll add a fourth thing, and that is to set your standards. Set your standards.
Yeah.
Like you said, I did have a standard. I knew what I wanted. So just setting a standard and knowing what you want, because a lot of people are single, but if you ask them, well, what kind of man or what kind of woman would you like to be with? They don't know. And it's kind of like when you're looking for a car. If you know that you want a Mercedes-Benz, you're going to see, it's like, it's weird. It's like you're going to start seeing Mercedes-Benz everywhere. But if you're looking for a car and you don't know which one you're looking for, you're going to see a ton of cars. And it's just like, you can't narrow it down. But me, I knew exactly what I wanted. So when Carrington came around, I was like, yes, like, he fits the mold of what I wanted. Although he didn't fit the mold of every single thing that I wanted. No, okay, let me not say it like that. Although he didn't... I had a certain type of guy, like, physically,
yeah.
And he didn't,
I wasn't tall enough. I wasn't tall enough.
Like, he wasn't.
I know what you mean. All girls have, you know, oh, he has to be this.
Specific. Mm-hmm. Right. Mm-hmm. So I was open to what God had for me at that point. But I did have my standards. So.
Okay. Well, that wraps up our interview session today. Thank you both so much. I know the viewers got their questions answered, and I definitely got mine as well. So thank y'all. In closing, if you are in or close to the Dallas, Texas area and would like to participate in the Dating with Purpose series or have a topic recommendation, please email all your information to ashleyofuku@gmail.com. I'll spell that out for you, ashleyofuku@gmail.com. All information is also in the description box. We are definitely looking forward to more submissions for upcoming episodes. And please follow me, EK3_ on Instagram. Follow @TheFitPastor and follow @AshleyEmpowers. That concludes our session for today. Thank you.